Welcome to what I think is been the most amazing weekend in Ithaca for a long, long time. To have this fabulous community partnership with the Hill and downtown all working together for 4 days of hip-hop. It's just spellbinding.
In modern times, when people say hip-hop, they just think of music, but it's not music at all. It's expression.
A lot of people feel that they can't make a living on something they love to do. And I love to do art. And my art became a spray paint.
Right? Yeah, it's been, I started in 1980. I've been painting ever since.
You know, I could draw the Mona Lisa on the wall. I could paint my name in graffiti. You know, I could do something for anybody using a spray can, just like I do with a pencil or a pen or a marker. I do it with a spray can. So that's a wonderful thing. And
the reason we use spray paint is because we didn't have art supplies. We were poor kids, and the first thing we saw was that spray can sitting under grandma's sink. We took that one, and then we took another can from somewhere else, and if we went to a friend's house and his parents had a couple of cans in his garage, that's how we started.
A Wall Street business guy was sitting there with a suit on, standing back, missed the train because he was looking at what I had done. You know what I mean? I was like, wow, check this out. You know what I mean? Little did he know who it was, and I would never at that time have gone up and said anything. You know what I mean? Because we were all kind of in the shadows back at that time.
I'm just really influenced by everything I grew up with, and, you know, it's... I mean, to see what I saw when I was a kid and to have had that experience of actually being there and watching trains go by and having that be my classroom.
For one weekend, little old Ithaca is the epicenter now of this culture that's just astounding.
You know, people came from all over New York to do this, basically all over the world. You got guys here, you know, all over the world. But they know that even though it's sanctioned, there's one or two people that aren't going to like it. You know what I mean? Because I was here the first day, and you had people saying, you know, don't do this, don't do that. And it's like, okay, but I'm going to do it anyway. You know what I mean? So it has to have that rebellion part of it.
Look, you've got the mayor doing the unveiling, right? The official formal head of the city doing the unveiling for graffiti, something 20 years ago, unthinkable.
People say hip-hop is dead. It's not dead. Depends on what you call hip-hop. You know, the culture itself is alive and kicking and thriving all over the world.
I love hip-hop, you know, so I'm into very much the concerts, the blogs, the albums. And there's always this question that lingers. There's always the question is, where is hip-hop going? What is hip-hop becoming? And as most staff have said, we are hip-hop. All of us who love hip-hop are hip-hop. So what we have to ask is, where are we going? Where are we headed? Wherever we're going, that's where hip-hop will go. You know, and I think that's the question we have to ask ourselves. Now that this is no longer a rebellion, what do we do with that spirit that still needs to rebel? And, you know, that's a question I don't know the answer to yet.
You know, if you'd asked me years ago if I'd still be doing this, I don't know, but it's something that just keeps you going. It's fun. Kids love it. My girlfriend's kid is here. He's like 12, and he's totally enthralled with it. He's into it. He's actually getting the opportunity to come out and paint. So I think we've got generations and generations to come of people.
So for young people, I would say that imitation, not just of the style of work or even this medium, isn't what's needed now. Imitation of the spirit of this work is what we need. Because this work was born out of people who were dying to, trying to, doing what they could to express themselves when they didn't have any other medium to do it. And that's really the spirit. It's not about the paint so much. It's not about the style of the paint. It's about the reasons why they were doing it.
From something that, you know, started out as graffiti, turned out to be like my lifestyle. This is my job, my work, something that I love to do. You know, it was a hobby, became something that art is my life now. You know, like I walk to the street, people say, "What's up, BG?" You know,
more boxes, more walls, more art. You know, we're running out of surfaces, we find, but so we're looking for more surfaces. I think 5 years from now, I think you'd expect to see some public art on our vehicles, city-owned vehicles, TCAT buses, possibly. I wouldn't be surprised if you saw some more street art. Now I'm talking about art literally on the street, on the pavement, in intersections. You know, instead of we're out there painting crosswalks white, what if we let somebody else paint it for us? And what if we didn't say you had to make it white and you had to stay inside the lines? So we'll see. We've got a great public art commission of volunteers who work very hard to make the city beautiful, and we'll see what they come up with.
You have all of this space of nothing. Put some color into it, whatever it may be, whether it's a street art or a local artist promoting whatever. Just, the world is beautiful. Continue the beauty of it.
The Cold Crush Brothers are here to do a sure shot throwdown for their very best friends.
Let's do it.
When I say how, then you say ho. And if somebody say thug, then you say so. Cause there's hell below and you ain't trying to go. So get ready for the throwdown. Let's get drunk and both get done. BDP, Cold Crush, KRS-One. Nowhere to hide, nowhere to run. So get ready for the throwdown.
Throw down, low down. MCs get thrown down. I'm massive, the set is chiropractic pronouns. I think you ought to go now. You can't stand the blow toe to toe now. That you heard all the rap criminals. Skills minimal, despicable. Check out the rhyme original. Indivisible with justice for all. Before you learn to walk, you got to learn to crawl. Before you learn to crawl, you got to be born. And before you were born, your folks had to get it on. The point to the matter coming from the blastmaster is hip-hop culture might be headed for disaster. All these whack rappers don't know the past data. They act like hip-hop history doesn't matter. So when you see KRS-One grace the stage, the difference that you see has to do with my age. Fresh in 74, fresh in 75, fresh in 76 when MCs rock live to cassette. Fresh in 77, don't forget. Fresh in 78 on a turntable set. Fresh in 79, fresh in 80, I was Grandmaster G with my man Neville T. Fresh in 81 and fresh in 82 with DJ Mad Mike off of Church Avenue in the BK. Brooklyn, Flatbush in the BK. MCs got mush. I was fresh in 83, 84, and 85 when I moved back to the BX and got live. Fresh in 86, fresh in 87, fresh in 88 after Scott went to heaven. Fresh in 89, fresh in 90, I'm fresh in 91, 92, and 93. Fresh in 94, 95, don't be forgetting. Fresh in 96 and fresher in 97. Fresh in 98 and fresh in 99. In the new millennium, I'll be arousing your mind. So
when I say how, then you say ho. And if somebody say thug, then you say so. Cause there's hell below and you ain't trying to go. So get ready for the throwdown. Heads get drunk and bumps get done. BDP, Cold Crush, KRS-One. Nowhere to hide, nowhere to run. So get ready for the throwdown.
What does it take to be a real MC? It means you can't write rhymes for the TV. Cause a real MC, whether amateurs or pros, is an MC that knows how to rock live shows. Another thing, while I sing MC talk, a real MC never diss New York. Cause if you knew the time while you're rhyming MCing, you know that New York is hip-hop's Garden of Eden. And if this ain't sacred, we never gonna make it. You're dissing your very old hip-hop tradition. You know why when I grab the mic I'm superior? Cause I was at the Roxy and Dance Interior. KRS a product of respect and currency, while the rapper is a product of the record company. I'm not bragging, but this is what hip-hop is achieving. It's becoming all rap and no MCing. Still we ain't seeing, and still we ain't believing. The West and the East, the hip-hop can cease.
Hey, y'all, yes, it's true. The boys in blue got a plan for you. And don't mess with the suits, cause they do too. So what you gonna do?
Stop biting on my crew.